An independent report confirms mistreatment of more than 450 students at one of Germany's most famous Catholic choir schools, and it says 67 were sexually abused. The reported abuse took place between 1945 and 1992. The choir was run for 30 years by Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI's elder brother, Monsignor George Ratzinger, who has said he was not aware of these allegations. Father Hans Zollner, a member of the Pontifical Commission for the Protection of Minors, joins us from Rome. Welcome to the program. How is it possible that abuse on this scale could have gone unchecked and is just now coming to light?
It comes to light because the bishop has taken a very courageous decision to open up the archives, to let an independent lawyer look into that, and he could produce that report, contacting survivors of abuse and asking all kinds of questions. And he has come up with this, which brought to light a horrible and horrendous story that has been going on for 70 years. Actually, most of this abuse has happened in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. But the point is that in those years and decades, people who could have known did not look at it. People who could have spoken to police didn't do it. And this includes, of course, the church leadership, but this includes also the parents and relatives of the children. I myself come from that city, and I know a few guys who have been on that school. I knew about that. When we were kids, they were talking about having been beaten up. But obviously at that time, the sensitivity about child rights and the violation of these rights was not as high as it is now. Punishment, corporal punishment, was considered more or less a normal way of education.
You advise the Holy Father on this issue. Tell us what the church is doing to protect children from predators.
Now, the first thing is that we learn from those experiences, and that bishops and leaders of the church as a whole follow that example, because this gives us the possibility to do at least a little bit of justice to all those who have been harmed in such a terrible way. And learning from that means that we, for example, in our institutions, do a thorough screening of all employees, all those who work in our educational, pastoral, social institutions, that we look into their past and present, that we see how they have had interactions with youth, that we give very clear guidelines and norms for all our institutions, that we do thorough training in initial and ongoing formation of all those who work with and for the church.
Thank you so much for joining us to talk about this very important issue. Father Hans Zollner, a member of the Pontifical Commission for the Protection of Minors.
Thank you very much.